This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for voriconazole and variation in the gene CYP2C19. This guideline was published in December 2016. Due to the low probability of CYP2C19 ultra-rapid and rapid metabolizers reaching therapeutic concentrations of voriconazole using standard dosing, and the increased probability of adverse effects caused by high voriconazole concentrations in CYP2C19 poor metabolizers, the guideline recommends the use of alternative therapies in these patients. There are currently 34 defined alleles of CYP2C19, known as star alleles. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 allele, which is designated as a normal function allele. Diplotypes of CYP2C19 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Note that, as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This can include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C19 alleles can also be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB voriconazole pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Voriconazole is metabolized by liver enzymes, including CYP2C19, to form a number of metabolites. This metabolism inactivates voriconazole. In CYP2C19 ultra-rapid and rapid metabolizers, the metabolism of voriconazole is increased. This reduces the number of active voriconazole molecules in the body, causing low trough concentrations. In CYP2C19 poor metabolizers, the metabolism of voriconazole is reduced. This increases the number of active voriconazole molecules in the body, causing high trough concentrations and putting the patient at risk of adverse effects. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for voriconazole. Patients with a CYP2C19 ultra-rapid metabolizer phenotype will have a low probability of reaching therapeutic voriconazole concentrations with standard dosing. An alternative agent that is not dependent on metabolism by CYP2C19 should be chosen for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 rapid metabolizer phenotype will have a modest probability of reaching therapeutic voriconazole concentrations with standard dosing. An alternative agent that is not dependent on metabolism by CYP2C19 should be chosen for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 normal metabolizer phenotype will have normal metabolism of voriconazole. These patients can be given voriconazole with the recommended standard of care dosing. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with the CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have higher dose-adjusted trough concentrations of voriconazole compared to normal metabolizers. These patients can be given voriconazole with the recommended standard of care dosing. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 poor metabolizer phenotype will have higher dose-adjusted trough concentrations of voriconazole compared to normal metabolizers, and may also have an increased probability of experiencing adverse effects. An alternative agent that is not dependent on metabolism by CYP2C19 should be chosen for these patients. If voriconazole is to be used, it should be administered at a lower than standard dosage in conjunction with therapeutic drug monitoring. This is a moderate recommendation. The dosing recommendations for voriconazole can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to voriconazole, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.